I remember the first albatross I ever saw. It was during a prolonged gale in waters hard upon the Antarctic seas.
Thank you.
I ascended to the overclouded deck, and there, dashed upon the main hatches, I saw a regal, feathery thing, unspotted whiteness, and with a hooked Roman bill sublime. At intervals, it arched forth its vast archangel wings, as if to embrace some holy ark. Wondrous flutterings and throbbings shook it. Though bodily unharmed, it uttered cries as some king's ghost in supernatural distress. As Abraham before the angels, I bowed myself. The white thing was so white, its wings so wide. And in those forever exiled waters, I had lost the miserable, warping memories of traditions and of towns. Captain made a postman of it, tying a lettered, leathern tally round its neck, and then letting it escape. But I doubt not that leathern tally, meant for man, was taken off in heaven when the white fowl flew to join the wing following, the invoking and adoring cherubim.